In this video, I'm going to show you the best way to create a coming soon page for your website or a maintenance page for your website. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. And I get this question a lot. How do I create a coming soon page for my website? And I wanted to answer and show you how to do that in this video. So first, let me explain what a coming soon or a maintenance mode page is. Essentially, when you're building out your website, you don't want people to be able to, or even Google or a search engine, to come to your website and see all these things you're doing, because it's probably not exactly ideal how you want it to look, right? You're putting it all together and you're intentionally not perfecting it because you're just putting the structure in, and then you're going to tweak everything, you're going to do all this stuff. And sometimes it could be kind of embarrassing if someone was to visit your website, or maybe you just want to keep it private and top secret. So you want to put it in a, maybe have a coming soon page where whenever anyone visits any page on your website, it's going to show them this coming soon page or this under maintenance page. They're different things, and I'm going to explain the exact difference. But these are the common times when you're going to want one of these options. So especially here on the channel, I show people how to build websites. I recently released an entire video series on how to create an online course website. So this question does come up a lot. So I'm going to do it in this video. Now, if you head over to WordPress.org and do a search for a coming soon plugin, typically you would just go and find a coming soon plugin, add it into your WordPress website, and then you'd have to figure out all the little nuances of that plugin. Now, the main one you're going to see recommended if you Google WordPress coming soon plugin is going to be this one right here from Seed Prod. And you can see right here, it's on a ton of websites. It's on over 300,000 websites. And I've actually used this before, and it is pretty good. It's not what we're going to use in this video, though, because I have a better solution for you. But this is limited to just creating coming soon or maintenance mode pages. Now, the negative of this is your pages, the pages that it generates, are very restrictive. You don't really have full creative control over those pages, and that's why these are kind of problematic. Now, maybe 2 years ago, these were ideal because page builders were still in their infancy. There wasn't these page builders where anyone can really create anything they want in a web page. So these were actually great to give you some structure and to give you something that looks nice. Now, I want to introduce to you what we're going to do. We're going to use Elementor, because Elementor is the very best free page building plugin for WordPress, and they recently added features to it to use it to generate or create coming soon pages and also to create maintenance mode pages. Now, the benefit of using Elementor is not just that it's free. I mean, it's free is great, but the benefit is you will have full control over these pages, and that's what I really like about it. Now, Elementor itself is free, but they also have a paid version called the Elementor Pro, and this is going to add additional features to that you can use on these coming soon and maintenance mode pages. But here's the thing, you don't need this, but there are a couple nice things that it adds that you may want to have. So one of them is, well, actually, let me scroll down to the main like features that it adds in. Okay, from a bunch of cool templates. Here it is. These exclusive pro widgets or elements. And the main one is right here, this countdown element that you'll be able to use on your page. So in order to get this countdown timer, if you want a countdown timer, I personally don't really care for them on a coming soon page. I mean, you can have it, but you could just as easily say coming soon on this date. You don't have to buy Elementor Pro just to get a countdown timer. And I've looked for free countdown timers. There aren't really any good ones, unfortunately. But it comes with all these different elements that you can use to make a powerful website. But of course, Elementor is not just for making coming soon and maintenance pages. It's for building entire websites. But this is just one more thing that you're going to be able to make with it. The cost of Elementor Pro, remember, you don't need it. It's $40 or $49 if you want it on a site. I have a link down below. Also, when you purchase through my link, I give you a course called Elementor Essentials. Now, let's go ahead and try this out. So I already have Elementor installed, but for you, you're going to need to go to plugins, click on add new, and then you're going to just do a quick search here for Elementor. So I've entered Elementor in. It's right here. I obviously already have it installed. You would just click activate and then install and then activate. You can see it's already on 90,000 websites. This is a very, very popular plugin. People are using this plugin to create some amazing websites and some amazing pages. But the benefit of it is you can use this to do some amazing things and you'll have full control. So once you install and activate it, you're going to have this menu option here that says Elementor. Now, let's go ahead and make ourselves a coming soon page. Now, I do want to preface this by saying this is going to work on any single website, every single WordPress website. It doesn't matter what theme you have, it's going to work on them all. So what we need to do is we need to click on My Library, and we're going to create a coming soon template in this thing called the library. So we're going to go ahead and click Add New, and then let's just call this Coming Soon. Okay, I've got that there. All I need to do now is click on Publish. Now I need to click on Edit with Elementor. So now it's going to open up in Elementor, this Elementor interface. Now, obviously, when the first thing you think of when you look at it, you're like, I don't want my coming soon page to look like this. I don't have a header designed yet or a menu or any of these sidebar stuff. This is what you need to do. Go ahead and click here on the top left, and then there's this option here that says Page Settings, and then it says Template. Right now it says Default, but we want to change this to Elementor Canvas. Now when you do this, it eliminates all of that stuff, so now you have this blank canvas to start building your coming soon page. So the way Elementor works is you click on the little dial pad right here and you just essentially dragging and dropping elements in there. You can have sections with background colors, background textures, you can have text, you can have buttons, you can have anything that you see here. It's really easy. And I have a bunch of videos already right here on YouTube, perfectly free to watch, where I show you how to make some very advanced designs. Right now though, we're going to look and see what added templates there are to Elementor for coming soon pages. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Add Template right here, and it's going to pull up a list of the templates. Now, I think there's a few coming soon specific ones. Now, I do want you to notice that on some of these templates, on the top right corner, you see it says Pro. These are templates that are only for people that have Elementor Pro, which I showed you earlier in the video. But you got to notice that they have beautiful templates whether you bought the Pro version or you're using the free version. They're giving you some beautiful templates. Like, look at this About Us page right there. It is absolutely stunning. And then here's another one that just happens to be part of the Pro package. So let's go ahead and scroll down a bit and see what we have here. You could obviously use any of these as a starting point, but I'm going to scroll down here because I know there are some specific ones, and here they are. Here are, let's see, nine coming soon templates that we can use as a starting point. Now, the main difference between the ones that are going to be with the free version and ones with the pro version really boil down to that countdown timer. So you can see this one here, coming soon one, beautiful countdown timer, but coming soon too, it's beautiful, it just doesn't have a countdown timer. So that is going to be your main difference between these various styles here. So I'm going to go ahead and choose, let's see this one here, it's got a clock on it, that looks fine. I'm going to go ahead and click on the insert button, and then it's going to go ahead and download everything that makes this template, and it's going to put it right here on your page. So this is literally how it's going to look. Now, the beautiful thing about Elementor is that you can click on anything and start editing it. So right here it says coming soon. I can click on it, and over here I can change it to whatever I want, and it adjusts in real time. You see that? adjusts in real time, and you can change the colors, the style, whatever you want. The same goes for this paragraph text here. The same thing goes for this phone number right here. I can click on it like this, and here is the phone number. I can click on there and change the phone number to whatever I want. Now, this is really cool because it's also showing that phone icon, but we could even change that icon to any icon that we want, and we can make it a hyperlink, but we're not in this instance. And the same thing goes for the email right there. So what we would do then is we would just go ahead and click on save. Now I want you to know you can create anything with Elementor. We can do something totally custom from scratch. I just wanted to show you how easy it is with these templates. Actually, we probably wouldn't want this M and R right here. Let's see what it is. It's an image. I wonder what happens when I delete it. It just pulls everything up. Let's just go ahead and delete it like that. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and click on save. Like that. And then when I click on the X on the bottom left corner right here, I can choose this option that says view page, and it's going to open up this page in a new tab. And there is this coming soon page. So now we've actually created it and we've saved it. Now let's tell WordPress that we want people to see this when they come to our site. So I'm going to go ahead and click on go to dashboard. And now I'm going to go back to these Elementor settings, and I want to click on tools right here. So now what we need to do is go right here in the section that says maintenance mode. And so we're going to click on choose mode. Right now it's disabled, but I'm going to choose coming soon. Now when you choose coming soon, it's going to give you a couple options. Number one is who can access. And this is saying who can access the full site and not get stuck behind this coming soon page. And this is going to always usually be set to people that are logged in. So what this means is when you yourself are logged into your website, that's when you can start editing and building your website. But if you're logged out and you come to your website, you're just going to see this coming soon page. Then it says choose template, and we just created it right here, coming soon. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on save pages. Now what happens is, and I really like this, and this is a WordPress feature, when you have this maintenance mode for coming soon on, you're going to have this big red indication right there. Maintenance mode on. And that's just going to let you know that the maintenance mode is on, and anyone that comes to your website right now, if they are not logged in, they're going to see that coming soon page. So for me, I am logged in. If I went to example website and I clicked on view site like this, it doesn't show me that coming soon page because I'm logged in. But if I go here to the right and I choose log out, it's going to take me, well, here I am at the login page, but if I click here to go back to the website, it's going to show me the coming soon page. And that's all I have, is this beautiful coming soon page. So now what I need to do is log back into the website. I can just click back and get to the login page. I'm going to log in really quick. Okay, now that I have my username and password, I'm going to click log in. And here we are. Maintenance mode is still on. So now let me go back to the front end of the website, and you can see now I'm able to edit my website. Now, when you are ready to let people back to see your website, you would go to Elementor Tools, and then right here where it says maintenance mode, we would change this to disabled. Now, there's also something called maintenance mode. Well, I mean, I'm getting it a little confused here. All of it's called maintenance mode, but the difference between a coming soon page and a maintenance page has to do with what your website communicates to a search engine. Okay, so if it's going to communicate coming soon, it tells Google, hey, we're building the website. You can index it. When it says maintenance, it says, hey, Google, come back in an hour or so, or tomorrow or so, and you'll get access back to the website. So it communicates something different to Google, and that's what these differences are. So, okay, so you would actually take it from maintenance mode, you'd put it to disabled, and then click on save changes, and then that would go away. So let's now create a maintenance mode, and this time I'll choose one of these pro templates. So I'm going to go back to my library, I'm going to click add new, and let's name this maintenance mode. Okay, I've got that entered. I'm going to click on publish. I'm going to click on edit with Elementor, and I am going to go and click on the top left here. I'm going to go into my page settings and change that template to Elementor Canvas to get rid of everything. Now I'm going to click on Add Template, and let's look at one of the ones that have a countdown timer, just so you can get an idea of what that looks like. So here we are scrolling down, and so typically maintenance is under construction or something like that. Let's go ahead and choose this one right here. Why not? This is a pro one. I'm going to choose Insert, and it's going to pull everything down. And it's the same thing. You can click on it over here on the left. You can go ahead and edit anything that's there. Now, this countdown timer is part of the pro package. And I got to say, it's one of the best countdown timers I've ever seen built for WordPress. It's so easy to use and so flexible with the style. So I can click on it right here and I can change my due date to whatever date I want in the future. And right now it's set for 2 days from now. So you can click in here and choose any day that you want. So let's see, today is the 28th of April. Actually, sorry, it's a month from now. So we're in April and we're right here. So let me choose the 29th. You can even choose a time just like that. And there it is, 5 hours, 32 minutes and 30 seconds. And you can even turn off some of these. If you didn't want the seconds to show, you could go like that and turn these seconds off. I really like all the power and flexibility here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on save. And then this time I am going to click on the X, go back to the dashboard. I'm going to go to Elementor Tools. And this time I'm going to put it in maintenance mode, but this time maintenance instead of coming soon. And I'm going to go ahead and choose that maintenance page we just created. I'll go ahead and click on Save Changes and then go back to the front end of the website. Same thing, if I'm logged in, I can access the website. If I'm logged out, I can't. So I'll just click Log Out here and then go to the root of the website. And there it is. And this is actually, wow, a beautiful template. I didn't know it was going to have this beautiful white frame around the edges. And it looks great with this background image. So essentially, this is a much more powerful way to create a coming soon page or to create a maintenance mode page for your website, because these are things that really should be done with a page builder anyway. Now, the reason there's these popular plugins, it's because they've been around for many years before we predominantly built websites using these page builders. But I think it's pretty visionary and forward thinking of the Elementor developers to go ahead and build this into their plugin, because it's the ideal plugin in order to do this. So if you did want to get Elementor Pro, I do have a link down below. Now, when you click on that link, it's going to tell you about the bonus package that I have. Essentially, if you buy it, I'm going to give you this training course on Elementor that I developed and recorded and I deliver on my website. The training course alone is $149, but if you purchase even the least expensive Elementor package for $49, you're going to get access to it. And you're going to be able to learn how to use Elementor to do many powerful things on your website, like create landing pages, beautiful designed pages and posts. You're going to learn how to do essentially everything with Elementor and build amazing and beautiful websites.